One best practice for analytics is to store variables used multiple times within a single analytic for later use. When we store the calculation result early in the analytic, we can use it later on in the analytic multiple times without evaluating it again. This concept can also be taken a step further by considering calculation results that are used in multiple analytics. Calculation results that are used in multiple analytics can be extracted into a separate precursor analytic with the results stored to a PI tag. The analytics that need this calculation result can then access the value from the PI tag rather than calculating it again. Although this creates additional analytics, which could be a problem in an already large-scale analytics deployment, the new analytic can often be scheduled less frequently. For example, an analytic that uses a 30-day average may need to be calculated every 5 minutes, but the 30-day average itself could be calculated on a shift basis every 8 hours instead. This is most often useful between different types of analytics. For an example, an expression analytic and an event frame generation analytic that use the same calculation result. Two expression and analytics can often be combined into a single analytic if the scheduling is compatible. In a general sense, combining analytics into a larger analytic is better for performance. The first step in this activity is to identify a variable or calculation that is used in multiple analytics. In PI System Explorer, we'll navigate to the library section. We'll make sure our turbine element template is selected. And then on the analysis templates page, we'll select the production lost versus average power production analytic. Next, we'll launch a second instance of PI System Explorer by right-clicking and selecting PI System Explorer. Then we'll go back to our library, and once again, our turbine template. We'll go to our analysis templates tab, and then we'll select the production lost EF template. So note that in both of these analytics, a 30-day average of active power calculation is used. In either instance of PI System Explorer, select the attribute templates page, and then look for the active power 30-day average attribute. So by expanding active power, we can find our 30-day average attribute. And then notice that it is a PI point data reference calculating the 30-day average and is therefore calculated on demand. Or in other words, when either analytic executes, this data reference will be executed and the 30-day average will be calculated. Next, let's go back to our analysis templates. And let's preview results on the production loss versus average power calculation. Notice that this calculation is being executed every 10 seconds. So every 10 seconds, the 30-day average for the average power, or the active power, is getting calculated. Statistically, a 30-day average cannot change significantly every 10 seconds, barring extreme circumstances. Yet this is getting recalculated every 10 seconds from this analytic, and also separately for the frame generation analytic. We can improve this performance if we calculate this active power for 30-day average in a separate precursor analytic. Our next step for optimizing this analytic is to build a new precursor analytic to calculate the common variable between the production lost versus average power analytic and the production lost EF analytic. So inside PI System Explorer in the library with our turbine template selected, we'll select the analysis templates tab and we'll right click and create a new analytic. And we'll call this active power 30-day average. We're going to set the first variable to our active power 30-day average, just like in the other analytics. And then we're going to map this output to the 30-day average stored attribute, which points to a pi tag. We created the pi tag before this lab, so you wouldn't have to worry about it. Next, we'll set the execution scheduling to periodic and configure it to be run hourly. With an offset of 0, so it starts at midnight. Next, we'll check those changes in. And then we'll go backfill our 30-day average for all of our turbines. Easiest way to do this is to create a new search and select our template. Finally, we'll modify our original analytics to use results from the new output tag rather than calculating the 30-day average multiple times. So we'll click into our library, and we'll make sure we have the turbine template selected and the analysis templates tab. We'll go to our production lost EF event frame, generating analytic, and we'll change average power to use our 30-day average stored. We'll do the same thing on our production lost versus average power template. Then we'll check in our changes. Now, instead of calculating a 30-day average every time they execute, each of these analytics will simply go to the 30-day average stored pi tag that we created with our precursor analytic. This is much more efficient.